Golden Lounge. It's Bobby Wagner. Wagner getting in for the sack. He's second on the season.
I'm now joined by linebacker Bobby Wagner. Bobby, thanks for taking the time with us today. I want to get straight to the matter kind of at hand. Earlier this week, Richard Sherman said, "You are the heart of the defense." What does that mean?
It means a lot. You know, I feel like I got a lot of respect from the players inside the locker room, and just shows how, you know, hard I've been working and the hard work that I put into this sport, and it's definitely appreciated.
Why are you so successful at this position?
I just think I have a knack for the ball. You know, I'm always running the ball. I always like to make plays, and, you know, I try to do whatever I can to make the players around me better, and they make me better.
You're a basketball player growing up, except I heard that you didn't get the extra 6 inches you'd hoped for.
Yeah. I wasn't 6'8" like LeBron, so I had to choose a different sport.
How'd the transition go from basketball to football?
Pretty good. I mean, they told me to find the ball, and I found the ball. And it was pretty simple from there. You know, you had a little complex stuff, but all in all, at the end of the day, this sport's simple. You know, you tackle the person who got the ball.
What's the secret to being a good linebacker for kids out there who want to do what you're doing?
The secret is play hard, run, hit, and just be physical. Every time the running back has the ball, he should know your number by the end of the night because you're hitting him so much.
Earlier this season, I asked Malcolm Smith about kind of your group as a whole, and I said, why don't you guys have a name? You got the Legion of Boom, but you guys, why no nickname yet?
Me personally, I feel like, you know, Legion of Boom have a name because they have, you know, guys who've done it for some time. You know, you got pro bowlers, all pros in their group. And I feel like, you know, in order for us to get a name, we got to, you know, deserve the name. And, you know, we're working towards that.
If you guys could have a name, any ideas, any suggestions out of right now?
I don't know. Me personally, I'd probably stick to something that's tied into Ninja Turtles. So who knows?
Yes, the Ninja Turtles. Now, I heard when you were in college that you had enough Ninja Turtle memorabilia to fill an entire room. Is that still the case?
Definitely still the case, especially I got up here. I mean, I kept everything, so, and my collection only grows, so that's something I like to do.
What's your favorite piece of your collection?
My backpack, Ninja Turtle backpack. Carry with me every single day.
Why is that your favorite?
My sister gave it to me a long time ago, and I just like it that much.
I'm sure you get this question all the time. Which Ninja Turtle?
Raphael, red one.
I was always personally attracted to April O'Neil. But
April O'Neil, I mean, she got her swag too, so no problem with that. You're a reporter just like she's a reporter.
The new Ninja Turtle movie came out earlier this week. Is that the Christmas gift you're buying all your teammates?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I got a lot of movies on deck, and I'm going to pass them out as a Christmas gift. I hope they like it.
How many times have you watched it yet?
I've watched it about 10 times.
Is it better than the original?
I wouldn't say it's better, but it definitely, you know, lives up to it.
Do you have any characteristics of the Ninja Turtles?
I like to whoop some butt, so I guess that's a good characteristic.
Perfect. Well, and I know the 12s love seeing you whoop some butt on the field.
Most definitely. I appreciate it.
Bobby, thanks for your time.
Appreciate it.
Aaron, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Michelle. Coming up, Game Day's Ian Furness joins us to go over three things to look for in tomorrow's game against the Cardinals.